Hey guys, it's your girl Basha. Welcome to Happiness Life. It's Monday, y'all, and we are going to get it. Yes. Why am I saying this? Because I know that, let's face it, we're all struggling. We all have our moments. I have my moments. I'm like, oh my God, is this world going to end? What's going on? And then I have to check myself. And what I've come to realize, what has really helped me, and this is what I want to share with you today, changing my focus and making sure I maintain a strategic focus on the end result. Yes, what do I mean by this? Well, I believe that what we focus on becomes larger. So if we're focusing on the problem, it becomes larger. This is a time for leaders, for winners, for you know, people who I call badass people to change this around. Yeah, if you believe that you will win, as Pitbull has just launched. If you believe that you will win, you're gonna win. You don't go into battle focusing on losing, focusing on doom. You have to choose your focus. And this is what we're gonna talk about today. What you choose to focus on. For some people, this is a time to complain. This is a time to imagine the worst, that they're gonna lose it all. And for others, they see opportunity. Now, those are the ones with faith. That's my kind of people. Now is a time to see, okay, what opportunities exist? The entrepreneurial ones. What business could be launched out of a time like this? Something's up. That's how I see it. This is a time for you to be able to decide, am I going to complain or am I going to anticipate what's next in a positive way? Yeah, people try to say that worrying is normal. Worrying is not normal. It's just a bad habit. It's something that we grew up thinking, oh, well, I'm only human. It's normal to worry. It's not normal to worry. It's actually a bad habit. So this week, it's Monday. Let's decide, what are the bad habits we're going to kick today? You know, what one of the things that that inspired my talk for today, for my Happiness Life, is this weekend, my husband and I, we did a drive-by because, you know, we've been maintaining social distancing. But we had to feed the kids. We have to feed them babies. So we did a drive-by with our mask on and everything. And we overheard this gentleman. We're picking up groceries. And we overheard this gentleman, you know, a man of a particular age. He seemed to be a decent human being. And he was complaining on his phone about this COVID and this hoax and this needs to stop, this nonsense. And I had to say to myself, what planet is this brother on? And he wasn't a brother, if you know what I mean. Because this is a serious thing. You're seeing the visuals. You're seeing people losing their loved ones. And there was no empathy coming from this human being. So this is a time that if you are in your sane mind, you have to choose love and kindness. You have to choose to respond with love. Be kind. Instead of focusing on yourself and what's going on with you, but look what happened to me. Guess what? It has happened to the entire world. It's not you alone, you know? And this is a time when, you know, let's put it this way. Suppose God was trying to test us all to see how much faith we really had in him. How much, especially those of us who are going to church every week and we are always putting up our hand, Jesus and Allah and whatever we refer to the Creator as. What if your God, your divine, your somebody, spiritual connector, was trying to test you during this time? What if he wanted to see if you could walk the talk? Now, it's easy for us to say, yes, I believe, but it's difficult for us to show that we believe. You know, I believe that love and kindness will always win. At a time like this, it's very important for us to choose kindness, choose love, choose forgiveness. Everything that happened yesterday doesn't matter today. What matters is what you focus on, because what you focus on will become larger. So today is Monday, and I choose to focus on winning. I choose to focus coming out on top of this and not at the bottom. The devil is going to be beneath my feet, and I will not be making Satan into a king. This is about a mind war. It's about what you choose to focus on will become larger. So you can't go into battle focusing on losing. No. So if this is a war, this is a battle, I know it can be difficult. And it's not just the media. When you have the leader of the free world insinuating that you can drink some bleach and, you know, inject yourself with some detergent, it's hard. I agree. It's hard. That took me down for a few minutes. I had to, you know, I had to say some prayers. But I choose not to focus on that. I choose to focus on the fact that we will get beauty for our ashes after this. This is a time to focus on things you always wanted to do. Maybe write a book. Maybe start journaling. Start yoga. I recently put up something on our site, bashatv.com, bashapowell.com. About, you know, 8 months ago, I started doing yoga and became addicted, and it's been transforming for me. It has helped me with anxiety spells. It has helped me with a few inches. Yeah. Find that thing that you've been putting off for a long time. Rediscover falling in love with your partner, if you know what I mean. You have a lot of downtime. You know, use that time in your house to rediscover your loved one, to spend more time. You know, I've seen so many things on social media, but I can't recall ever seeing so many families playing board games. I remember my childhood when there was no Facebook, no, and I'm not knocking Facebook or anything like that, but we need a balance to connect with each other. You know, I remember we'd play Monopoly, Scrabble. That was childhood. We'd be able to connect with each other. Find, refocus, choose what you focus on. This is not all bad, all doom and gloom. And as I said, okay, suppose the world is going to end. You want it to end with you being unhappy and being gloomy and dumb? I don't think that's a good idea. You need to end with it, you know, get up every morning and dress. Just look snatch. Just, you know, you just get those edges laid, whatever you say. Get yourself feeling beautiful. Because when you dress for the opportunity, you are already executing your vision. It's in motion. So what's your vision going to be? Is it going to be doom and gloom? It's Monday, y'all. Let's go get this. Yes, it has happened. But we can put this behind us by the way we go about it. What are you going to choose to do? Call somebody and complain about this virus and it's ridiculous? No. Choose to help somebody. Choose to connect with your loved ones. Choose to start an activity, a hobby, a business that you've been procrastinating about. Write a book. Do something about it. Don't just become a statistic. Be a leader. This is a time when winners would win. Are you a winner or are you a loser? It's your girl, Basha. It's Monday, y'all. Let's go do this thing. Basha style. Let's go.